Labor Day's here. Let's buy Mom a tree cake. We use the same mold as the whale cake, but we paint a tree on it. Use your credit card and come in for a nice, thick, rich caramel ice cream cake. And now, enjoy the show.
That's the one you chose to work on for the last, what's it been, 3 weeks? The Carvel ice cream guy?
Yeah! Carvel ice cream up in this mother!
That was time well spent. Very nice.
You remember Carvel? I'm sure you do, huh?
Nope.
No?
Nope.
Not at all?
Nope. Wasn't around then.
Guy had the most disgusting voice for advertising food. Anyway, we got episode motherfucking 17 up in this biatch! Here we are, Idol Effect, episode 17, I believe, right?
Yeah, but you're going like all rap on this. I was gonna go like winger.
Oh, were ya? Oh,
she's only 17!
Yeah, I guess I should start thinking ahead about the number of the show and then maybe line it up, because this has nothing to do with,
you know,
17.
Daddy says,
although,
she's too young, but she's old enough for
I'll
me.
Say, I think Tupac took about 17 slugs.
That's weird, Dave.
I don't know.
But it's rap, so I
don't
care.
Yeah, yeah. That's just the way it is.
How's everybody been?
Yes, I'm Chuck Ellis. How are you? This is Jerry White. We're back. Idol Effect episode 17 coming at you in full color. That's right.
We got new equipment.
New equipment. So if you're watching on YouTube, I think you notice the difference, because I see it.
And if it doesn't look any better, don't tell us, because it'll just break our fucking hearts.
Yeah, just write us and tell us how much better it looks regardless.
Just lie, because I don't want to spend the money for no reason.
So here we are.
But where have we been?
Yeah, that's the question.
The question
on everyone's mind, and your favorite segment. So
it's not my favorite segment. Bathroom Adventures is my favorite segment, and I think you know that.
No, I'm sorry, you're wrong, Jer. I believe it's no. Actually, where have we been? Not your favorite, but
you can go ahead and tell it anyway.
But we do it anyway, so
I'm gonna let you go first and tell me where you've been.
You tell me,
because I'm fucking dying
to
know.
I am trying to remember, so I brought some notes here.
You had to write down where you've been.
Well, we had Thanksgiving, so
we did have Thanksgiving,
and I went to the buffet with you. We did our family.
We got our turkey on.
We did that. So not a lot happened there. No adventures
with the lamb and mint jelly. Gross.
That's right.
What the fuck's
lamb
up with that?
And I was excited about that, because you were like, they got a lamb over there with mint jelly, and it just sounded good. I'm like,
nasty.
Yeah, it wasn't. Yeah, but all in all, buffet, pretty cool experience.
Not bad.
Easy
bad
way to do Thanksgiving.
No fuss, no muss.
Fucking in and out, goodbye, nice seeing you. And
we're still talking about the buffet, right? You didn't go somewhere else that I should know about, man.
Went to the usual, all the usual stops.
But you know, I had my wife make me a turkey anyway.
Oh, really?
After the fact, yes. She made me a post Turkey Day turkey.
She thought she was getting out of it, and then you got home and you're all, oh, by the way.
Gotta have my sandwiches.
Because we did have an early dinner, so yeah, there was plenty
Football
of time.
Football Sunday sandwiches.
Yeah.
Gotta have them.
Well, thanks for the invite.
Oh, wow. You don't watch football anyway, you fucking puss.
Well, you know.
You're like a croquet, like squash kind of guy.
Yeah, curling.
Curling.
Extreme ironing, I really enjoy.
Extreme ironing.
So
nice.
It's a big time sport, you know, somewhere.
In your pants.
That it is. And I also, my band, Mighty Jack, we played at the Hood Thanksgiving Eve, which is, that's a show I always wanted to play, because people come into town, people that have moved away. Back when we were younger, it was people who went away to college would come home and visit their parents. Now it's just people have moved away with, you know, and had started their lives, but they still come home, and then you see, you know, all these faces like, hey, what's happening, you know? So I figured Thanksgiving Eve, that's the night to play, because they all go out that night.
Because the people that have figured out that it sucks here and left.
Right, yeah.
Get roped back in for old family connections, and then you can drag
the
their ass
the one night a week you can catch them here in the desert, so. But the problem is, my friends, a lot of them, not so much. They're done. So it was a lot of new faces
that
I saw. People did come into town, but I didn't know them. But it turned them on to Mighty Jack and turned them on, you know, got some new fans.
It's adorable that you think you have friends. That's cute as fuck.
And we played, I decided that this was the night we were going to retire we always cover Sweet Transvestite by, from the Rocky Horror Show.
Oh.
How'd you do? Super Mad Mike. But I decided, hey, look, let's retire it for a while. We've done it a long time. You know, it was fun, but everyone expects it now. So let's just kick it to the curb and do a new funny song from a movie. And right at the end of the set, we're saying goodnight. And, you know, this is all right. This is going to be our last tune. And this big guy walks up. Hey, transvestite. I don't know if he was talking.
Was he requesting or was he announcing?
Yeah, very good, sir. We're happy for you.
Turns out he just chose that time to come out.
Happy Thanksgiving. Good job. So we...
you should see it.
He ended up being... I guess he was one of the security guards there. Big guy. And I said, you know, I'm not going to wrestle you for it. We'll go ahead and play it one more time. So.
Which is unlike you, because usually if a big guy shows up and wants to wrestle, you're all
down. I'm stripping down and pouring the Jell-O mix.
Greasing up.
Back to Thanksgiving. I did the old classic Twilight Zone.
Oh.
The old Twilight Zone marathon, which they used to do here, you know. Submitted for your approval. Jerry White, a 55-year-old podcast.
Hey! You don't announce how fucking old I am.
Podcast host who doesn't realize, but he's just decided to podcast
in the Twilight.
But I was wondering, did you do Turkey Day Marathon?
You mean MST?
MST, Mystery Science Theater.
I did not, but what I did do was Star Wars, you know, Phantom Menace through Return of the Jedi marathon on TNT.
Oh, shit, yeah.
But I'm not totally stupid. I'm just only partially stupid.
Oh,
so
wow.
So I recorded it. I know.
That's a revelation.
It's,
wow.
That's big news.
You heard it here first,
yeah.
Folks.
So I DVR'd it.
Did you?
So I could at least fast forward, you know, like through like everything in Phantom Menace except for Darth Maul.
Yeah, yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Because that's just all...
All politics.
Painful.
You didn't want to watch the Senate, like, debating on whatever happened?
But you know what I determined after watching all those things again?
That you never really liked sci-fi or Star Wars.
No.
You were just kidding yourself?
No. Stormtroopers just suck. Stormtroopers, they can't fucking shoot.
They did.
They can't hit anything. If the Empire didn't have, like, just overwhelming freaking technology and ships, and if there was just an even playing field, they'd be done in, like, 5 minutes.
Right, yeah.
Because they can't shoot.
Always an Achilles heel, and that's training their troops, I guess.
Oh, fuck. I mean, they recruit these guys at, like, the optometrist or some shit. Hey, you. No. The Coke bottle glasses. Come here.
Now, in the first New Hope and Empire, are Stormtroopers... clones of Jango Fett? Are they still clones?
Yeah.
Because I'm thinking maybe they just cloned the wrong guy.
They cloned the guy with no fucking eyesight. Yeah. I don't know.
But yeah, they not the sharpest sabers in the
And then I watched whatever. I watched Force Awakens again. And I know this is blasphemy because, you know, it was... Oh, what's his name? Director.
Abrams?
J.J. Abrams. It was J.J.'s deal and all. And I'm not saying I didn't like, but is it okay to say that it wasn't fucking fantastic?
Yeah, I know. Oh my god, are you kidding me?
It was.
I know. No, you know what? I thought,
you know, I tried to be on the bandwagon. I tried to be like, oh, it's just fucking best thing since sliced whatever. And it's just not. It's
sliced midi-chlorians.
You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of an X-Men movie.
Right.
Good, but not great.
Yeah, except everybody wanted it to be great. Everybody just said it's great.
I think you're just kind of, you know, said, fuck it. You know, it's just, we're calling it great because it's JJ and it's been a while and we don't want them to stop making them.
Yeah,
and we've even preached that point.
They finally figured that out.
You know,
that's good.
Don't bag on it. So that's good.
Go out and
You know what? It wasn't.
Go out and praise it. Praise the fuck out of it and say how good it was because we want more. And it worked.
I'm hoping Rogue One is better.
Yeah, yeah.
Than Force Awakens.
I hope so too. I'm looking forward to it. What bothered me about Force Awakens is that it was kind of another Death Star, it was bigger. And it's kind of you. There's got to be some other tale they can tell, you know.
Well, I want to see. I mean, and I know that you know that we still have Luke in the next one.
What? Spoilers.
Yep, okay. Whatever. But I kind of want to see what happens when they get away from, you know, or at least hopefully get more away from the original cast.
Right,
and
yeah.
kind of take it, you know, in a direction that doesn't involve all those people, because, you know,
right,
now yeah. that Han Solo's dead, spoiler!
Yeah.
you know, let's just move this shit along, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
So, I don't know, we'll see. But Rogue One, I'm hopeful, being a standalone movie... You know, where they don't have to attach anything to it when it's done.
Right, yeah. It's just got to follow the story. I mean, we know the story, basically.
Yeah, it's just got to be in the timeline right. and got to have the canon. And then,
right, right.
And hopefully yeah. that one is a standalone kick-ass movie. Hopefully.
And I'm thinking it will be.
Yeah, but what are you fucking
And whenever I think that,
it
you're
sucks
in trouble.
Balls. Yeah.
Now, I did recently, I won some Disneyland tickets. And
okay.
Well, it was kind of a cool way. It was the radio station locally did it. They're like,
thanks for the invite.
Right. Well, I mean, it was sort of a spur of the moment type of thing. The radio station, I hear in the morning, they're announcing how they're like, all right, everybody. Well, here. it's 52 degrees. 7 before the hour. I want everybody to get in your car. We've got a game to play. If you find Mixie Mouse in the city, first one to find her gets a 2-pack to Disneyland. We want you to go. I want to send you there to be the first to find her. But right now, here's a twofer from the one and only Rod Stewart. Coming at you. They announced to go out. Basically, they hid somebody in the city. This was like hide and seek, but it encompassed the whole Coachella Valley. Could be Palm Springs. Could be Indio. I decided, when I heard this, I'm going to go... They said, we'll be announcing the clue to find her shortly. So I decided, I'm going to get in the car. It's 7 a.m. I'm going to go down to the mall. The mall's pretty centrally located, right here in Palm Desert. So I'm sitting there. I get in the... 7 o'clock rolls around. They're okay. Here's your first clue to find Mixie Mouse. Now, Mixie Mouse is a girl dressed up as a mouse who has the tickets.
I figured that yeah. far down, but thanks.
And they say... Okay, you might find these people here. Brody, T.S., Wilhelm, and Bob.
Really?
Yeah.
Does this person know you or something?
I
gave you a mall rat's clue?
You'd swear the fix was in. And
the
I'm,
fix was totally
in. I'm sitting at the fucking mall. And this could have been in Palm Springs. It could have been 13 miles, you know, west. It could have been 13 miles east. And I'm sitting right at the place where it is. I'm like, holy shit. And no one else is going to get this clue. No one else listening anyway. I'm thinking there's very few that are out here doing this. They're going to sit there and listen to that. So I start circling the mall. I'm looking. I'm like, it's got to be the Palm Desert Mall because it's not going to be the fucking Indio Mall. Or the I don't even think the Palm Springs Mall exists
that's
anymore.
That's how sad we are. There's only one mall. Yeah,
basically only one real mall.
Yeah, so,
like,
you know.
Genuine mall. I'm circling it. I circle it 4 or 5 times. I can't find this mouse. I can't find anybody. It's early in the morning.
I can't find this fucking mouse.
And then they finally get to the second clue. I'm like, no, no, no. And it was like an obvious clue. It was like, you can do your Halloween trick-or-treating here and your Christmas shopping. I'm like, oh, shit. Now everyone's going to know it's the mall. But I'm still already there, so that's helping me. And I decide, I circle a couple more times, I see another car, they're looking, and I decide, finally, last minute, I'm going to go up in the parking garage, I'm going to go upstairs and just take a look real quick. I don't think they're up there. Sure enough, I get up there, and there she is.
Wait a minute.
Poised by the elevator.
So she wasn't inside the mall, she was outside.
She was outside, yeah, yeah. Because the mall wasn't even open yet, so I figured, she's not inside. You can get in, but it's dark. Yeah. So I get to the top of the parking garage. Frenchie.
Oh, okay.
And there she is up at the top. And you had to say holidays was the code word. So I pull up. And I'm all holidays. And
she's like,
who the fuck are you?
I'm like, how do you know my safe word?
We haven't even started yet. So yeah, I got myself some Disneyland tickets. So, which is nice. These days, Disneyland, $100 or so. Give or take,
more
right?
Than that,
more than that, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
That's when we're going.
Well, I gotta see if I can't win another pair so we can all go.
Okay, well, if you don't, then when are we going? Because obviously you and I are going and.
Right, right. And the women are staying behind. And
yeah.
They're gonna cook us turkeys for when we get back so we can have sandwiches.
No, it's sandwiches.
Sandwiches. See it, right. Now, I also went to...
You've been a busy guy.
Yeah, it's been a while. I went to see the legend, a friend of mine, that gig we played the other night, the Thanksgiving Eve gig. I saw a friend of mine there that works for a local, say his name, Brian Blue Sky. He works for CV Independent.
I see him on Facebook all the time.
Yeah, he's all over Facebook. Yeah. He's all over everything. So
really?
He works for CV Independent, and he did an interview with Wayne Newton. Then about an hour later, he gets a call, hey, you're going to get free tickets and backstage passes to Wayne's show at Morongo, our casino here locally. And he's telling me the story. He's like, no, what sucks is nobody wants to go to that show. It's like nobody wants to go to that one. I'm like, guess what? I want to go. So I got to go. I got to even meet the man. I don't know if you people listening can't see this, but here it is, me and Wayne Newton, the one and only.
Wayne's had some work.
I'll show the. You think? That's the only one thing I was going to say. Most people are going to say, "Dude, you're at the Wax Museum." That's not. But wow. No, that's the Wayne Newton. So that's my old neighbor from back in the day.
Newton is your old neighbor from back in the day.
Sort of. When yours too, actually, because we both lived in Vegas in the '70s at one time, right?
Oh, okay. So you're just Vegas
not,
in general,
not
okay.
Next door neighbor.
I
but,
thought it did be Val Vaughn. Yeah, really.
So I didn't get a lot of time to talk to him. I asked him if he still had the peacocks because those he used to have peacocks hanging outside his.
He said you're coming on to me.
So how'd you know my safe word? So anyway, I got to meet Wayne. I also saw Sturgill Simpson.
Said that 5 times fast.
Sturgill Simpson. Sturgill Simpson is kind of an old school country guy. He's kind of rockabilly, kind of old school. He's the only country guy I can actually stomach, like, that's new. And he's good. I mean, he's brilliant. His show is brilliant. And I saw him at the Wiltern Theater.
This is country, right?
This is country,
You're
yeah.
attaching the word brilliant to country.
The guy's really good. Well, he adds a little... He's got something. I can't put my finger on it, but he's got something. He's got a horn section and...
If you could put your finger on it, would you immediately want to wipe it off on something?
Like, probably so. I might have two or three fingers on it.
One of the painting.
But the problem is, we went to the Wiltern to see him. And the Wiltern Theater, I imagine they're not the only ones. But you figure for a little theater, you're just going to find... They're going to have their own parking lot and it's going to be fine. Maybe $5 parking. It was $25 parking. And then when you get inside, two beers were $30. $15 a beer. Is that the norm now?
Plus, well, that's a little high, but you have to keep in mind, too, that just by walking into the place, you probably contracted, like, free gonorrhea. So.
That's true, right.
You get that bargain.
Yeah.
You walked out with some sort of STD, so, you know.
You get the perk. You pay for the perks.
Yeah.
They don't, yeah. But, yeah, I don't know. I mean, I remember when we went to Rush years ago at Irvine. That was the first time I experienced the $8 beer.
The bend over?
Yeah, yeah.
Bend over beer.
I was like, $8? And then I had to that was back in early 2000s, and, like, I had to think about it. Like, do I really? Yeah, I want a beer. All right, sure enough. Yeah, $8. Serve it up. And then I probably went back and got another one. Now they've doubled it.
Sure. Captive audience.
I mean, they know you're going to pay, but at what point? I mean, it's just not right, is it?
No, it's not right, but unless you can get everybody in the place to go, you know what? Fuck you, we're not doing
it. Yeah.
Then they're just going to keep going.
It's a travesty, but, like, where does it go from here?
It's a trap!
It's a trap!
That's better.
Where does it go from here, and when does it stop?
It goes to 20 and 20. It's pretty simple math. It just goes up.
It just keeps going?
Yeah.
And going and going and going.
Sure.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, it's just not right. And the parking, too. How do they sleep at night? I'm not blaming it on Sturgill Simpson, too. He's awesome, and his show is worth whatever. The tickets were $100, and that's pretty much normal these days. And I'm not blaming it on you, Sturgill. You're not the one. But
it's kind of like South Park when they talk about, like, David Spade or Adam Sandler. David Spade is a talking duck.
Right.
He's now the president. And it quack, quack, and it doesn't matter. Fuck you. You'll go anyway.
You'll go and watch it. Yeah.
Exactly.
So I guess
it's kind of like that.
Makes sense. Yeah. So, all right. We're fine.
Quack.
Fine. Wiltern and probably a Galaxy. Probably every theater out there. This is the way it's going to be. And yeah, I will pay it.
Yep.
I'll be there.
Settle in.
You know what? Just make your beers $100. Make it an even $100 and I'll pay it.
You say that shit now. And then next time you go.
Next time I go,
fucking
bitch. Yeah, yeah.
Well, we heard it on your show. We're the person that listens. It was us.
I'd just be happy that, wow, you listen? Great.
Awesome.
I'll just say the one last place I went.
God, where didn't you go?
The other day,
I went to do a segment on where we haven't been. It would be easier.
Well, there's no movie review, but I was going to say, I went to Albertsons.
And, oh, God.
And I was...
Really? We're going to talk about the market now?
This is really quick. I was in there, and I was, I don't know, over looking at the yogurts or something like that.
Okay.
And all of a sudden, over the PA, I hear, Martha, line one. Martha, you have a phone call on line one. And the first thing that popped in my head...
Of course.
You knew it. And before I could even say it to myself, you hear across the store somebody else, Martha! So,
why did you say that name?
So I thought that was kind of cool.
That was kind of cool. That's probably the best story out of all of them.
It is,
the
definitely.
Last one, yeah.
That's why I saved it for last. Yeah. So.
Oh, where did I go?
You went somewhere else, I know that.
I went to Meekum. Do you know what Meekum is?
I have a feeling
that
it's a car. I can mail without him. That's sold American engine. So how was it?
It was good.
Yeah.
We went up there. I tried to buy Johnny Carson's old Mercedes.
Ooh.
I know, right? It would have been the total perfect
idle
effect car. Right?
I'm thinking it definitely, that would have been awesome. You're going to surprise me and say, you know what? Actually, I did buy it.
Nope.
And it's downstairs.
Nope.
Fuck.
I was the high bidder, and they wouldn't take the reserve off.
Had a fucking reserve.
Yep.
That's bullshit.
I know.
It must work for the Wiltern.
It still had the old car phone in it from back in the day.
Really? Johnny's
old car phone.
They used to call Ed on it.
Yep.
Oh, shit.
It was Wimbledon white, because Wimbledon white was his favorite color.
Uh-huh.
Because he's a huge tennis player. You know, somebody who, like me, comedy writer who grew up sneaking out to the living room in the middle of the night when I was a kid to watch Carson
edgy Johnny Carson.
Well, you know, back then he was the guy.
He was
the man.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, so yeah, that would have been cool to have.
But it would have been nice. Yeah.
They wanted me to up my own bid, and I was like, up your own bid.
Who told them?
Yeah, I know, right?
Well, if I would have known about the phone, shit, you should have called me. I would have thrown in $10 or so.
Good. Ooh, $10, huh? Okay, against my thousands of dollars, you're gonna throw in $10.
I mean, that's the phone he probably talked to, whoever. Who was he banging? He probably banged a lot of chicks too, huh? And Margaret, maybe.
I don't know.
Hello, Anne. This is Johnny. Yeah, you want to be on the show? You know what it costs. You know what it's gonna take. Meet me in my dressing room. Ed'll be there, right, Ed? Oh, yeah. I don't know.
Stop it.
Well, is it still up? I mean, is it maybe going to come back around?
No.
Is it gone for good?
When they don't sell a car, at Meekum it goes to what they call the bid goes on. And then you can go over...
La-di-da-di-di.
Yeah. And you can go over to this bid goes on desk, and you can, if you want to throw more money at it, you can.
Really? Yeah.
And I thought about it a couple times, and I'm like, you know what? Fuck it. Take it home. So the guy took it home.
Yeah.
I bought something else. So fuck him.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Did you get like George Burns's Ferrari?
No, actually, I came back home, and then McCormick's auction was here in town. So Sunday I went to that and ended up buying a little Toyota Dolphin camper.
Nice.
And a 73 Chevelle Laguna.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I know. I came home with all these fucking cars.
So now we have two idle effect moments. We have one that we can stay overnight if we go long distance.
Yeah, and or if this whole thing goes belly up, we can live in the
fucking car.
Yeah, which is probably the most likely scenario.
Yeah.
Sleeps three comfortably.
Well, cool. We can pick up somebody on the way and
have
our way with them.
Okay, you just tagged that on the end. I was kind of done, but sure, have our way with them.
Hey, why not?
Yeah, why not?
Have our way. All right, so where else you been, or are you about done?
I think I'm up for Dad of the Year award.
Are you?
I think so. Because I took my 13-year-old to see Bad Santa 2.
Ooh.
You know... I saw Bad Santa, the first one.
Yeah.
It was raunchy, but it wasn't off the rails raunchy.
Right, yeah.
And it was Thanksgiving, my daughter was home for vacation. My wife was working.
Yeah.
So I thought, well, you know, there was nothing else. I didn't want to go see some Disney movies, so there was nothing else to watch. There was nothing else out.
It's a Christmas movie.
So, yeah, you know, I thought, how bad can it be? So so I took her.
We'll show you how bad you
are. Oh, my Lord. You know, and they would keep doing shit, and I would keep going, okay, well, that's got to be as bad as it gets, right?
Yeah,
so
right, she
already heard that part, so fuck it.
Yeah,
you know,
crossed the threshold.
But then the next thing, and then the next thing, and then... To the point where people were actually started turning around because we were at the top and looking back like, you still here? And I'm like,
they're turning the house lights on you, the spotlight, this guy.
And then, what did they call it? Felching? Is this, am I using this term right? Felching? Do you know what this is?
Is that the,
okay, now I'm going to pre-warn everybody.
That's not the thing from Deadpool where she, no, that's pegging, where she was banging him with the,
okay,
didn't get that bad, right?
Consider yourself pre-warned.
Felching.
Felching, from what I understand, from what they said in the movie, is when you come inside someone's ass and then take a straw and then suck that back out again. Why anybody would do that, I have no idea. But they're talking about it in this movie. And I'm looking at my 13-year-old and she's like...
And yeah.
And then the people in front of me turn around like, now?
Felching?
And I'm like, come on, a little more. So, I don't think she got that. Thank God. I think that flew over her head.
Right. Luckily, it got into the part of the movie where it got...
Because that was just
too extreme.
That was all, you know, they weren't doing it. They were just talking about it. Felching. And I think it sailed over her head.
Yeah.
So, I'm like, okay.
She led you to believe that it did.
She didn't get that part. I was like, okay, fine. That's got to be it. But then 5 minutes later, Santa's fucking...
Double felching.
Santa's fucking some girl in the back alley against the dumpster. And I'm like, okay, we're out. So as Santa's on the screen, fucking this girl in the ass from...
You're walking
I'm
out
walking
there.
My 13-year-old daughter out of the freaking... like this. Is... Oh, Lord.
Oh, gosh. Oy vey.
Bad Santa. Well, take the family. I highly recommend it.
So as a public service announcement, as a service to you... Jerry endured these glaring stares.
Yeah.
and basically just he's blackballed, but now you know, don't take your child to Bad Santa too.
Plus the worst part is I didn't get to see the end. So I don't know how
it
came out.
Yeah. I know how it came out.
Yeah, stop. So anyway, that was nasty.
Well,
let's go talk about something else. Let's talk
no
about.
No wonder everybody was staring at you at the buffet and pointing and like.
That's the fucking guy from Bad Santa.
Yeah.
Nice job, Belcher.
I'm like, oh, we're not with him. There was just no more seats.
I'm like, yeah, that's right. Yeah, anyway.
So.
Let's talk about some trailers.
You want it?
Let's talk about something that's not just totally disgustingly X-rated gross.
Okay. All right. Well, this is kind of cool. Finally, the Guardians of the Galaxy trailer dropped. The real trailer.
The actual trailer, not just couple of shots that they just threw together with scotch tape and said, here, watch this.
Yeah, yeah. I don't even know why they threw that out. It's like, we know what the characters look like. Let's get down to a real trailer. Yeah. And they did. That's kind of cool. So, it appears that it's going to be all Baby Groot. Like, I thought maybe...
Yeah.
We were going to...
Right.
Groot was going to grow and... Maybe the Baby Groot scenes were from the beginning or
but they're
flashbacks.
Actually letting Baby Groot do
he's
action
gonna fight.
Stuff.
Yeah,
so,
yeah,
yeah.
Hey,
you know, whatever.
He's even got one of those little Ravagers jackets on, like Star-Lord, and he's doing...
I didn't notice that, but okay.
Yeah, he's wearing kind of a little, like those guys, the Ravagers that took Star-Lord. Yeah, he's wearing one of their suits, so... Yeah, he's... So we get to see... He's taking down somebody, killing him, I think.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Felching him, at least.
Stop.
So,
don't make me sorry.
I'm thinking maybe since he's Baby Groot, maybe it's going to be like yoga hosers and he's going to run up their butthole. like the Bratzies.
Really?
Nine!
Don't mention yoga hosers with Guardians.
Nine!
In the same freaking...
Wonder Bar! But we don't get to see... We see Abelisk. I think it's called an Abelisk. That big being that Drax is...
Yeah.
It looks like he gets in, he's swallowed, and inside he's
yeah,
like trying to kill him from the inside or whatever. And
like indigestion.
Basically, yeah, it's like the Pinocchio syndrome, I guess, whatever. But Pinocchio syndrome. Now we don't get to see. We still haven't seen Ego, the living planet.
I thought that was Jonah.
What's that?
Isn't Jonah the one that gets swallowed inside the whale? Pinocchio is just a fucking puppet.
You're probably right. Is it Jonah or Geppetto?
Geppetto is the person who built Pinocchio.
Right.
And how I notice, I have no idea because I don't watch Disney fucking movies, but Jonah is the one that gets swallowed by the whale.
Okay.
God, get your references.
No,
straight. They
both do, basically, right?
Pinocchio gets swallowed by
a whale. There's a whale in it. Yeah, it's two different stories, but yeah, they both do. Maybe Pinocchio's writer stole it from Jonah or vice versa,
This is a very important point, so we should get this right. Because
people are going to be writing
in. It's
going
to be pivotal to anything we talk about.
They're
going to
be writing in and saying, hey, dude, get your fucking Pinocchio. Actually, if it made him write in, then it's probably a good thing. Let's just be clueless and go, I don't think Pinocchio got swallowed by a whale.
He got felched.
They haven't found the Titanic yet. So
that's weak.
I'm just trying to get people to write in and say, you're wrong.
I got it.
So, but... we don't see Ego. We don't see Kurt Russell yet as Ego, the living planet. So we don't know what that's going to look like.
Or maybe
yet.
You did. Maybe that whole thing, they were just running around on top of him.
Could be. Yeah. Oh, yeah. This isn't a... what's in Empire Strikes Back when they're all, this isn't a cave? Or
yeah.
Yeah. Could be like that. He's going to be
this is no cave.
Yeah. Those aren't pillows. Yeah. But we do see Mantis... at the end of the thing. She's the one who reads the minds and... And she reveals Star-Lord's deep, dark secret that he wants to bang. Yeah. What's her name?
Shakira. What's her name? Yeah.
Shakira. Another person we haven't seen yet is... Adrian. He's going to be in it.
As what?
I think he's a Nova Corps member.
Well...
So we get Stallone. We get a... Yeah.
Okay.
Well, he's a badass.
Why?
I don't know if it's like, if it was like, okay, there's only one person that can play this part, and let's hope...
And we couldn't get him, so we'll use Sly instead.
Hey, I'm open, I'm a bag, I'll do it, yo. I don't know what it is, if they just wanted to have Stallone in it. I mean, cool, I guess, you know, whatever.
Sure, whatever.
Yeah. He's going to be a Nova Corps member, and I don't know if he's going to be using all, if he's really pivotal, and he's going to be using all his Rambo skills, and...
Yell Judge Dredd on him.
Yeah. I'm the law. But I don't know. We haven't seen him yet. But from what I've heard, he's a Nova Corps member. And Vin Diesel actually is the voice of Baby Groot, from what I heard.
So why?
They've just altered it. Yeah.
They just feel like they need to throw him a bone. Or
yeah. I guess so. But he had a quote. And this is kind of a spoiler. Kind of not. But
well, which is it?
Well, you decide. He said, I know that somewhere in the universe you are going to see Groot and Hulk battle. You can write it somewhere. You're going to see that poster, Hulk versus Groot. So either, I guess maybe he knows something or he's just speculating.
Or he's just fucking high.
Yeah, right. So. Whoa! That's my Vin Diesel and my Stallone are pretty similar.
Yeah, but see, Vin Diesel doesn't sound anything like Stallone.
Hey, yo, Vin! What?
That, no, see, have you ever seen Vin Diesel do anything?
Hey, Vin, we got Guardians of the Galaxy! Oh, that's right, we did.
That doesn't sound like him at all.
It doesn't?
Vin Diesel does not sound like
him. All right, give me your Vin Diesel.
Oh, I don't have one, but that's not it. I'm not the voice guy around here,
not,
that's
not,
you.
It's something like that, isn't
no,
it?
No, it's not.
No, I live every day 1 mile at a time or something. What's that?
But you keep doing it, though, it doesn't make it any better, just... It's just more of not good.
More of bad.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, all in all, though, cool trailer. Looks good, huh?
Yeah, no. Actually,
my impressions aside.
This section of trailer talk is like the first time where all the trailers I actually watched, I'm actually excited about.
You enjoyed all three?
Yes. Okay. I thought they were all good, and I'm like pumped to see them.
Right on. Right on.
I'm felched to see them. I'm ready.
Well, then let's give them the next one. I bet they're excited to know.
Bring it, bitch.
Okay, this is the first installment of the new Universal Monster shared universe. Now, Universal was the one who started the shared universe back in the day. They had Frankenstein meet the Wolfman, fucking Dracula meet Abbott Costello. So, The Mummy. The Mummy trailer dropped.
You know, you gotta stop being such a fucking homer about the Universal stuff. You really do.
Well, I kind of grew up on that shit.
Yeah, you're just way too over the top.
Watching Channel 5 at night, you know, they... I dig that shit.
You're not 90.
Well, anyway, the Universal Shared Universe, their first trailer dropped, The Mummy. Tom Cruise is the, the protagonist, I guess, in this? He's sort of a Van Helsing character?
Oh, I really don't know. It looks pretty good.
Looked good? One thing I know is you liked it, so...
I liked the trailer. It looked pretty good.
Looked cool. That plane, they were on a plane, and the mummy is on the plane with them, and it starts going down.
Well, all the birds fly in or whatever.
Birds flying in, yeah.
But, I mean, is this supposed to be, a remake of, the Tarzan dude mummy movies, or...
Yeah, it's a reboot. It's an absolute reboot.
Okay.
So,
Because those movies weren't bad. At least the first one wasn't bad.
They weren't bad, but they're just starting over. They want this shared universe to be like Marvel is. They're just starting everything over. It's all rebooted.
Everybody wants to be Marvel.
Right. Exactly. So, and Tom Cruise going down in this plane, you know he does all his stunts, so they actually crashed a plane with him in
it. Did they?
Yeah.
So, I just enjoyed the fact that you said Tom Cruise going down. like it wasn't a given already.
Yeah.
Of course he was.
That's what he calls Monday through Friday. So. Mm,
yeah.
And now one key note, because people thought 2014's Dracula Untold, they were going to include that. That was going to be canon in this new shared universe. Well, apparently it's not. So whoever's Dracula, it's not going to be whoever was in that. Shia LaBeouf or whatever.
If you had his name, would you actually pronounce it LaBeouf?
No, it'd be like LaBeal.
Something,
yeah, a little
anything
more.
Anything but La fucking Boof.
La Boof.
Fucking La Loser.
And then we do get a shot of Russell Crowe. Russell Crowe is playing Dr. Jekyll.
So, is that who he's playing?
Yeah, he's Dr. Jekyll.
Oh,
so
okay.
He's right. So in The Mummy, I guess.
So they don't really. How do you know that? Because they don't really tell you that in the trailer.
Well, it's been leaked. It's been
it's been leaked
and confirmed.
Was it felched?
It was, yeah. It was felched. It was bukkakeed. It was...
It was LaBeouf.
Yeah, it was LaBeouf. So, yeah. But, don't know if we're going to see Mr. Hyde take on the mummy, but my guess is we just might. It might be all they can do to stop him or her.
That's your educated guess. We just might.
Yeah. Because we get it, so it's a female mummy. It's a hot mummy, actually. She's got four eyes, but, you know, hey, I never let that stop me before.
I'm not touching that.
Well, I am. So, anyway, Kong, Skull Island.
That looked really good, too.
That looks cool.
Yeah.
Now, this obviously takes place before they took him to New York and killed him, I guess, because he's on the island and alive.
Don't sweat the freaking small stuff, dude. Who cares where he fits in the timeline? But it doesn't matter.
Either that or he healed. They bandaged him up, put him back on the island. But it looks cool. Looks pretty awesome. And
you guys shouldn't have come here.
Yeah.
That's fucking awesome.
John C. Reilly is... Yeah. He's a guy amongst
the natives there.
Yeah, we're all gonna die
here. We're all gonna die.
They go in and it looks like they're bombing the island and they... They piss him off, piss off Kong, and then hijinks ensue. But John Goodman's character apparently knew Kong was there, so it's all a big thing to get proof that there's big monkeys.
So I have a question for you.
Uh-huh.
In all the versions of Kong, and you could safely say that Kong's been pissed off in every single one of them at one point or another, and usually most of the
usually
time...
Usually at aircraft.
Yeah, and most of the time, usually pissed off, angry.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen him once throw his shit at anybody. Shouldn't you see him just grab a big, huge chunk of his fucking... and chuck it at fucking somebody?
If Kevin...
Isn't that not what they do?
If Kevin Smith directs the next Kong, or the guys that did Harold and Kumar, we may see that. But no, I agree. I think that...
On top of the freaking, the Empire State...
Yeah,
chucking his fucking shit at fucking planes when they're trying to shoot him. I mean,
well, if it can be tastefully done, I'm sure they'll
no one cares about tastefully done anymore. That ship has sailed with Belgium.
Well, when Kong 3D comes out, I'm sure it's happening. And it's coming your way.
Hopefully we can get it in like a splooge vision. That'd be great.
You'll go see it at, Universal.
Go see Bad Santa 2, the splooge vision.
Take our kids.
Oh. He does a little bit of Felch.
So, hey now. Imagine if your name is Felcher. How you doing? I'm Tim Felcher.
Yeah, I'll be changing my name.
How you doing? So, all right, well...
Moving onward, upward.
Yeah, I was going to say, we're 2017 is right around the corner, and we got a big year
coming. Not a moment too soon.
Right, exactly.
2016.
This year...
It was pretty fucked up.
It had its bump. Yeah. Wasn't easy, so...
Yeah, anyway.
Well, 2017 looks good. You know why?
Why?
Because it kicks off in March with Logan.
March, that's... Not January. That's not kicking off.
Well, we got to warm up. We've got to recover from Rogue One because it's going to be so awesome. Imagine so. March 3rd. It's early March anyway.
Okay.
Right, almost before my birthday. So
Logan has a real chance to suck,
but a real chance not to.
No, I know, but it's 50-50.
It could be either.
I don't think it's going to be comedy.
Okay. It could be...
Or go it could see be... Logan, the Laugh Riot of 2017.
No, I think it looks cool. The only thing is, they did the whole old man... It's not really the story, old man Logan, because they can't really do that story, because that involves Hawkeye. Too many characters that Fox doesn't have. So it's, but it is an old man post-apocalyptic story, obviously. But I think they should have saved that, because even though... Hugh Jackman said, this is my last time, I'm done, no more. He would have done it later on in his years. You figure, like, say 10 years down the road, 20 years down the road. You want to play Logan again? You want to play Wolverine? Let's do old man Logan. Which he still could.
How do you know?
How do I know what?
That he would do it. You don't know.
Well, he's done it so many times, I'm pretty sure he's... 20 years from now, when he's doing nothing, I'm sure he's going to jump in, you know.
How do you know in 20 years he's doing nothing?
He'll put on the yellow suit from the Marvel comics.
Best years of his fucking career. And say, you know what? You.
He might.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'll say, fuck you.
Fuck you, man. What am I doing?
Hi, Mr. Jackman. Would you like to play Logan again? Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Or, hey, fuck you, mate.
There you go.
Why don't you have a Foster's and fuck off? I'll shove my qual up your ass.
You should have stopped it, like, fuck you, mate.
All right, well, I won't go into...
Okay.
All right. Now, okay, anyway, I'm running down what we got coming next year, comic book movie-wise. So, Logan.
It's going well so far.
March 3rd, then, of course, we just talked about it, May 5th, Guardians of the Galaxy.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
We got the trailer, we basically talked about that one. Then, next, the month following that, like, less than a month later, June 2nd, we got Wonder Woman.
Wonder Woman! Is that long before Wonder Woman comes out?
It is, yeah.
That's a long ways.
It's going to be a while. That trailer... Well, DC likes to put out the trailer 2 years before the movie comes out. Like, the movie's shelved for, you know how Superman Batman was.
It's going to need me some Gal Gadot before then.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I'm sure she'll do something. She may come here and be on the show. Have her right here. Actually, let's bring her out. Come on, everybody. Give a hand for Gal Gadot. Which reminds us, don't we have a guest tonight?
What?
And we have a guest, Fernando, isn't he?
Oh, Fernando?
Yeah, we're gonna.
No, he flaked on us.
Oh, he flaked.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought he was gonna come out one of these doors
after he bashed on me.
I have a whole list of questions for him and his movie. We have a friend, Fernando, who's making a movie.
Right.
We even have a list that's dedicated. It's just for him.
Yeah. Well, what are you gonna do?
Well, what are you gonna do? There was something in the air that night.
Stop
you
it.
Fucking flaked that night, Fernando.
Okay.
7/7, July. July 7th.
Yes.
Spider-Man Homecoming. Ooh, yeah.
And will he have a Tony suit?
I think it's going to be Tony-ish.
Okay.
Tony-esque? Tony-esque, yeah. He's going to be battling Michael Keaton as the Vulture. So basically, Michael Keaton's playing Birdman after Birdman.
I was going to say.
Yeah, Birdman!
That sounds convenient.
Yeah. So it's just cool. I'm glad. And there's also going to be an appearance by. It's kind of funny that they're still calling him this, but the Shocker. You know what they? You know.
No.
The shocker is it's like felching, but with hands.
Okay.
It's two in the pink and one in the, that's two in the pink and one in the stink is called the shocker. It's another name for it.
How do you know this?
Well, you know, I know a guy that knows a guy that likes to shock.
This show has come off the
fucking I thought everybody knew that. I thought that was common knowledge. Your kid told me. She's
probably did after fucking bad sex.
So, but I'm looking forward to that. They say it's going to be kind of a John Hughes-esque sort of movie. Like, they're doing it. It's like it's high, he's back in high school, and it is going to have Iron Man. There is going to be some Tony Stark play in there. But, yeah, they're going to do it like... I don't know. That's kind of cool when they say John Hughes-esque. I don't know how close it would be.
They just know what it takes to get you in the theater.
Yeah, yeah.
Will there be an after credits? It's over.
With a John... Yeah.
Go home.
That's gonna. Yeah, that's kind of funny because that's full circle. John Hughes kind of... He's the one that started the whole after credits thing, I think. Maybe. And then September 4th. This is not a movie per se, but the Inhumans television show starts on September 4th.
Well, it's not a movie at all.
But...
Not per se.
The first two episodes will be shown in IMAX theaters on September 4th. So, it's going to be kind of like a movie because they're going to show the first two episodes.
I see.
So, but it's TV, so I'm kind of wondering if... like, because originally they were going to do the Inhumans movie.
Well, I mean, they've got Inhumans all over Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. right, yeah, now. So, well, what's the point of having... this.
Well, that's how they're trying to shove the Inhumans down your throat. Like, look, Inhumans. You like the Inhumans? Here they are. Because they don't have the X-Men. So that was kind of their next. But they haven't showed the real Inhumans. They haven't showed the royal family, like Black Bolt and Triton. And
they've been trying to shove like Ghost Rider down our throat, and I don't really care
if it's
Ghost Rider.
Yeah, if it's not Nicolas Cage, man, it's not Ghost Rider for me.
I don't care if it is Nicolas Cage. Ghost Rider, and he right. doesn't even ride a bike. He drives a Dodge Charger.
He rides around in a car. Yeah.
I mean, Mopar guy, that's fine.
That's cool. But,
you know, whatever.
They thought they'd go after you. We'll get Jared. We'll put him in a Mopar. So, but, I mean, but this is going to center on the actual royal family. So you're going to get Medusa, Black Bolt, the dog, Lockjaw, the big bulldog.
So,
go ahead.
This is going to be brilliant, so I'm just warning you up front.
Okay, here we go.
So, being Black Bolt, if it's a non-speaking part, does he get paid?
Oh, come on!
Joe, jeez.
Come on.
Up.
Jesus.
Right here. Don't leave me hanging. Right.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
High five, and what do you people think? Does he get paid? Does Black Bolt get paid? That's right.
Please tell me you got that.
They're getting it. It's just sticking in there. Thank you. Thank you.
I was proud of that one. Don't go there.
Okay, so we get the... We'll go see that, right? We'll go to a IMAX theater somewhere and see the Inhumans.
Yeah.
Now, 11-3, November 3rd. We're looking almost a year away, but the one I'm waiting for, Thor Ragnarok.
Are you waiting for it?
I'm waiting for it.
Was there another option besides waiting?
Yeah, I could just go see it now, but that'd be hard. It's easier to wait. I might get arrested trying to see it now.
Good for you.
And they're saying that one is kind of like a buddy thing between Thor and Hulk. It's kind of a midnight run. Like they're comparing it to Midnight Run, but in some other realm.
So which one is Charles Grodin?
Good idea. Yeah. I would think that Thor is
I'm on fire tonight, by the way.
You are, totally, yeah.
Damn it.
I don't know. I guess Thor would... Well, it's probably a rhetorical question anyway, right? You don't want an answer.
Your answer is irrelevant.
So I see the theme here, though. They're saying Thor is like a midnight run. Spider-Man Homecoming is like a John Hughes thing. So they're just re-channeling the 80s in these movies. Yeah, I don't know. This is universal for re-channeling the 80s. So.
It's like you're fondling your balls.
Right, yeah. So maybe Justice League is going to be like Top Gun.
Yeah.
So that's the next one we got. We got 11-17.
I think you could probably stop there. That's a whole year from now.
Justice League. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to stop there.
Okay.
But...
And in 2023...
No, I just wanted to run down next year's movies. So just so people know what's coming.
Not even breathing hard yet.
There's only one other thing I want to mention about 2017. Boy. The Las Vegas Golden Knights NHL team inaugural season begins. My hometown Vegas Knights. are starting their season. I'm going to be a hockey fan now.
You are the only fucking person who cares about that.
So, hey, what can I say?
Now, you know, if the Raiders move there...
That's a possibility. Huh?
The Raiders actually have a... I hate the Raiders, but they actually have a good team this year.
Right, yeah. I'll always be a Rams fan, so will you.
Yeah,
so,
fucking
even man. If whoever goes to Vegas doesn't matter.
In the words of your boy, welcome to my nightmare.
Who's that? Who says that? I'm sure. So anyway, real quickly, this is a new segment.
You keep saying real quickly, and yet it never is.
Goes on. Fun fact I heard. Well, like fun fact. It's almost fun. You know, in the movie Civil War, Captain America, when Tony Stark is sitting with Spider-Man, or he's talking to Spider-Man,
in his room.
Peter Parker in his room, and he says, move your leg, I'm going to sit here. Do you remember that part?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, fun fact, that's not in the script. His leg was in the way, and he said, move your leg, I'm going to sit here, and they just kept it in. So, interesting. So, yeah. I don't know. Fun fact. Like fun fact. So next episode, you come out, you bring a like fun fact.
No, I don't
And
wanna.
We'll trade off. No?
No, I don't want to.
Okay. All right, well, we could get into some news if you like.
Sure.
Oh, I was going to say, don't answer that.
Okay.
So, in the news, a man has been banned from flying Delta after he went on a pro-Donald Trump tirade. Did you hear about this? Did you
know about this? Pro-Trump?
Pro-Trump tirade.
That's different.
Yeah. Delta Airlines has permanently banned a man who went on a rant about Donald Trump while on board one of its planes last week. The man was flying on Delta Flight 248 from Atlanta to Allentown, Pennsylvania, when he went on a political tirade. Donald Trump, baby! The man yelled. Wait, this will need some more music. Different music for that. This is... Donald Trump, baby! The man yelled at passengers on the plane. We got some Hillary bitches in here. Come on, baby, Donald Trump. Donald Trump is your president. Every goddamn one of you. This is his quotes. And if you don't like it, fuck you, it's too bad. So.
Fuck you, it's too bad.
Basically. And after the video of what happened was posted to Facebook, he received over 2 million views. The company's CEO said he would refund the customer's cost of their ticket. The other customer's, not his. And he will never be allowed on a Delta plane again. So.
Which may, at some point, just save his fucking life. Delta is so...
Probably.
Delta's the worst, man.
But what a... I don't get why this guy... It's not like it's his... sports team, or what is it about this guy that Donald Trump is going to do for him? You know more about this. What is it that...
Why would I know more about
this? This is like a good old boy. He's wearing the... He's got the gas monkey t-shirt, the hat back,
which
and he's like...
Which begs the question, the why would I know more about this?
I'm
not a good old boy or country or political, so why would I know more about this?
Does he think Donald's really going to build that wall? Because I don't think the wall's going to go up.
I don't know.
I think he's going to scrap it. And I don't think anything's going to change with the guns. He's going to get to keep his guns no matter who's president. I think if anything, this guy's disability is going to go away under Trump or something. So he probably shouldn't be too...
Maybe he's just liquored up, dude. Fucking, I don't know.
It could have been. I don't know. Whatever. Anyway.
Yeah, anyway.
He's a big Trump fan.
Yeah.
Okay, now, did you hear LeBron is staying in a different hotel?
I didn't know LeBron was staying in any hotel.
Well, I mean, when they play somewhere and they stay in the Trump hotel, when they play New York, he's going to stay as a protest, I guess. He's staying in a different hotel.
Fucking whatever.
Well, yeah, whatever. That's what I say. So here, you've heard about the police that announced that they'd be, if they caught drivers under influence, this is Canadian police. If they catch drivers under the influence, they're going to get not only a hefty fine, but they're going to be forced to listen to Nickelback in the cruiser. You hear about that?
You're making that shit
no,
up.
No, it's Kensington Police Service in Prince Edward Island, Canada, announced that when they catch a driver under the influence, they will not only give them a hefty fine, but they will also force them to listen to the office's copy of Nickelback in the cruiser on the way to jail. Well, that was reported last week. This week, it's been reported Canadian police apologized to Nickelback for using the group's music as punishment. A police department in Canada has officially apologized to Nickelback for threatening to make drunk drivers listen to their songs. They were hoping Nickelback's music would be an extra deterrent, but now they say bullying in any form is wrong. So basically, it was sort of a backhanded apology. They're saying, bullying is wrong. We're sorry, Nickelback. We're not going to make them listen to your music because we feel we're bullying them. So,
do Canadians fucking hate Nickelback or something?
I think everybody... I don't know. What do you think? You be the
Nickelback?
You know, I'm half Canadian and... Yeah, I half hate them.
I don't... I mean, they're... You know... There's some Nickelback I like and some Nickelback I don't like, but it isn't.
You
like,
heard it here, folks.
But it's not.
Jerry loves Nickelback.
But it's not like you're throwing them in the back of a cop car and making them listen to Cher or some shit. It's Nickelback.
Right, right, yeah, yeah.
You know,
I don't know. At some point, really, actually, yeah, they're just another. You know, they're okay, but it's at some point Nickelback became the poster child for just like the band's. People hate the just the cheesy rock.
Yeah, I get
country
that.
Rock.
They're like, you know, they're like Def Leppard, only worse.
Right. Yeah.
But this is not about that. This is about this is what happens when Canadians try and be funny.
Right. Yeah.
It goes fucking south like this, and it turns into a thing. It's a stupid thing, but a thing nonetheless.
There, sorry, Canadians. Yeah,
yeah stop.
Good
trying.
Try,
stop.
Nice try.
Yeah,
good effort.
Ha ha, Nickelback. How we
good effort,
we,
Canada.
We get it. Yeah, good so. One.
All right, well, I got one for you. This is this news report here is tailor made for you. In the news, private flights to the moon should be available by 2026. That's right, Chair. Moon Express founder Naveen Jain plans to be selling lunar flights for $10,000 per seat. The first rocket Moon Express will fly next year on a historic mission to the lunar surface. That's what I'm going to do, Tom. We're flying it. The company's MX-1 lander perched atop a Rocket Lab Electron booster will cost about $5 million. So their prototype they're sending next year with a robot.
So when you get on the computer to book this flight.
Yeah.
This is when it really matters that it's like round trip.
Right.
You know, I don't think if it's not round trip, I don't think I'm booking flight.
I doubt they're gonna have that option of one way.
Yeah, I don't think I want the one way flight to the moon. I don't
But you wanna go, right? You would go, right? Knowing you,
I'll go in year two.
Yeah, I'm not going in 2026.
Yeah,
no,
I'll go in 2028 when they've got it dialed in and I get to pick whether I want chicken or fish.
Yeah, no, it's coming back. I think I would wait until I was probably in my 70s, just in case. Like, that way if you know, something happens, if I go, I go.
Well, I'm not really sweating the age, I want to make sure that, you know, nobody else dies first before I go die.
Right, yeah. So you figure 1 year is good enough?
Because if they have like 10 successful flights and then I fly up there and I die, well then fuck, it was my time.
Right, right.
But if I go on the first flight and I die and people on the second flight die and people on the third, then we're just all fucking idiots. I don't mind dying, I just don't want to look stupid doing it. That's all.
Well, I imagine you probably have to book these well in advance and it's 10 grand.
I'll spend $10,000. That's cheap to go to the moon. And back?
To go to the ship itself is cheap. $5 million. I don't know if I want to fly to the moon on a $5 million.
Yeah,
spaceship.
I need to see it.
I would think it'd have to be like $1 billion ship, and then it's like, yeah, sure, $5 million. That seems like it's did they make that on their computer?
Yeah, I'll believe all that when I see it.
Right. Yeah. Well, it's happening. So, the government's already...
They said it's happening.
It's not happening. Well, the government has approved them to send the prototype next year with a robot. So, 2017 is going to be their first landing on the moon.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully. Supposedly.
Supposedly.
Yeah. And then in another 10 years... Well, another 11 years you're going. In another 10 years, they're going to start shipping people up there. So...
Mm-hmm.
So I got time to save up if I want to help you with your ticket, too. Okay. I don't know. But I'm going to wait until I'm old and it's... I really know it's my time, just in case.
You're a puss.
Yeah. So anyway, two all beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions, anise, sesame seed bun. Do you remember that?
No, I've never heard that before in my life.
Okay. Well, that was of course the Big Mac slogan.
Yes.
And Jim Delegate, the man who created the Big Mac, which went on to be one of the world's best known sandwiches.
He's either suing somebody or he's dead.
He's dead.
He's
dead. And that's the news.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Did he have a Big Mac attack?
Oh, man, I'm on fire God, tonight. You are just lighting it up, man.
Oh, man.
Give it. I'm telling you.
Oh.
Okay.
It's not easy being this cheesy.
It's not. Now, have you seen or have you heard? Have you heard the new Metallica?
I have not.
It's... what's it called?
Ham sandwich?
shit sandwich. High strung to something. Ah, fuck. What? Well, it's out.
Just save me the trouble. Is it any good? Because I don't know.
Well, it's funny. I was going to ask you, because I'm kind of at a point where I listen to it. I'm kind of at a point where I can't tell if a Metallica record is good or bad anymore.
Yeah.
It's like I've lost that ability. I don't listen to the metal anymore, so... I listen to the old stuff that I listen to, but when the new stuff comes out, I can't tell. Is this good? Or just would I have liked this when I was, you know, really into this shit? So, but I know you're still a metalhead. You're still fucking rocking. You pull that shit out, and you're like, fucking, this sucks. This is good. This is shit. That's good. Fucking, you know what you're talking about. You know your shit.
You done? Fuck. Now, I sound very angry about it too.
So I don't know. It sounds okay.
Okay.
It's yeah. But what's funny about it is, well, it's, I guess it's not too funny. Kirk Hammett, the guitar player, lost a phone. So he didn't really have much of a contribution to it, I guess, because he lost his phone with 250 riffs, like on the. Yeah, I know. he had 250 riffs for the next Metallica record that he was going to work through, and he lost them all. On this phone. And it kind of reminded me of you when you said you turned in your old phone and you had material for the show. And
right.
Now we all suffer through what I've got.
Yeah.
So if it's not good, blame fucking Kirk Hammett for losing his phone and James Hetfield for not being able to write. But yeah. So I don't know. But.
Okay.
The good news for Metallica fans is I happened to find that phone. I got a couple.
Here we go.
Now, I'm going to return it to him. But this is Kirk Hammett's... Got a couple rare little gems here. That's Kirk Hammett warming up there. There you go. See? So I don't know.
Is it just going like this, or...?
I don't know if this... I don't know if this would have done much for Metallica. I don't know. So anyway, I'm going to return that to him. I'm going to get that back to him. But I don't know if that would have helped. I think they're better off maybe without his new riffs.
It sounded like a bumblebee orgy.
You would know, huh? Yeah, take it. Take it all.
That's definitely a bumblebee orgy.
Show me that beacock, baby.
That's a BDO.
So anyway.
That's annoying as fuck, dude.
Yeah, it is. Now, one thing. Have you seen the pic of Mira for the Aquaman movie?
No.
Well, that's the only thing
I'm amusing myself now.
Yeah. Well, I think it's actually from Justice League, but... they finally shown actress Amber Heard in her Mira
I don't know that
outfit.
Character, so.
Well, it's Aquaman's wife. But it was reported like a couple months ago that they asked her not to show up because she wasn't camera ready. But then this picture showed...
Is that another way of saying she was fat?
Basically, yeah. But this picture showed up and it's like, I should have had it to show you.
Is she camera ready now?
if not being camera ready is wrong, I don't want her to be right. She fucking looks. This is going to be your new favorite. You're going to forget the Black Widow when you see Mira.
No, I don't think so.
That's what I'm saying. That's all I can say is.
There's no way she's better than Gal Gadot. No way.
I don't know, man.
No way.
Yeah. You got to check this thing out. So, I think they just threw us off the scent when they said, "Oh, she's not camera ready. She's not happening." And then boom, they throw this up, and it's like, whoa, what the, come on now.
So she has a scent too?
Yeah. So,
wow.
If anything, there's between Wonder Woman, Godot, and Mira, there's going to be some hotness in Justice League. So,
oh, let's hope that's.
That's not all there is.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So,
yeah. Hope they bring more to the party than that.
Yeah. Yeah. So, Aquaman will not be out until 2018. It'll star Jason Momoa as the titular hero. Titular.
What?
Titular hero, Arthur Curry, a.k.a. Aquaman, and William Dafoe as Nuitus Volko. He's like an...
I don't know.
He's an Atlantean politician guy.
See, I'm not going to know anything about that because, like everybody else on the planet, I don't give a fuck about Aquaman.
Yeah, okay.
No, don't care.
All right. Well, you will.
And I like Jason Momoa. I mean, I actually kind of sort of know Jason Momoa, but... and that's back from like the Stargate Atlantis days.
Right, yeah, when you used to hang on the set and party with those guys.
Yeah, fucking A, Johnny.
Fucking coke and...
Yeah, you know,
fucking
blow and...
Uppers, downers, all-arounders.
Yeah.
So.
But, yeah, you know, and I'm sure it'll be fine.
So
but
when you talk to him next time, you're going to tell him to your face, I don't really like Aquaman, dude, and I probably won't see your movie, but, you know, good luck with that.
Yeah. I'm going to tell him exactly.
Okay. So,
I call him Jace.
You call him? Yeah?
Jace.
Good old Jace?
Yeah. No, not Jason, just
Jace. I'd like to meet him sometime, since you know him so well.
$5.
So,
what else you got?
I got,
herpes?
Yes. Well, okay, I was wondering about, YouTube. We're on YouTube.
We are.
Hi, everybody.
God, that was gay.
Hi, everybody.
Who picks the thumbnail? You know, if you go on to Idle Effect at YouTube.idleeffect.com or whatever it is, when you get to
our YouTube channel. Yes.
And each episode has a picture, like a thumbnail.
Yes.
Does that automatically go up, or do you pick like that second in the?
It's automatically done for you unless you choose your own.
Really?
Okay. I don't care enough to choose my own.
Oh, okay.
So I let the thing randomly pick what we get.
Okay. So I was thinking maybe you should start caring.
Why, is there one of like, we hold my junk or something?
Basically, yeah. No, it's just, they catch us in the most unflattering. Some of them are okay, and then some of them are just like...
Dude, it's us. They're all unflattering.
You're right.
If you're looking for... I'm not going to spend hours trying to find a flattering one-second thumbnail in our show, because I got other things to do.
Maybe we should just put a picture of your buddy Jason Momoa and Leo DiCaprio next to each other. And
maybe we should just throw
we might get more listeners, more viewers.
Just throw the graphic up on every episode. Just don't even put our faces on it.
Well, the faces thing actually works cool, because you can tell it's a different... Like, if you just put the graphic each time, it doesn't... show any it doesn't differentiate, but at least we're wearing different shirts, different color shirts, so you know, oh, that's a different episode than that one.
I don't know about different color, because I almost always wear black, but different shirts, maybe.
I almost always wear black, but I'm wearing red today, but yeah. But you can tell the difference, so I'd say just leave it as it is, but if you wanted to...
Phew, because I was gonna go to the trouble of changing all that, but since you said that,
if you wanted to really, if you wanted to get into it, you could.
That was never gonna happen.
Could find better screenshots, but I'll be fine. It's okay.
I know you will.
Now, Now you usually say that I wanted to do a list.
Because you usually do.
Okay. So go ahead and say, you wanted to do a list.
I'm not going to say it now.
Okay. Well, I wanted to do a list. Now, this was going to be because Fernando was coming, and Fernando is making a Kevin Smith-like movie, right?
He says he is.
Okay. So I figured we'd do a list of our top 10 Kevin Smith projects. Like, it can be... Kevin Smith has his hand in a lot of...
Easy.
Careful. You know, he's a jack of all trades. He's got books, he's got TV shows, he's got podcasts, he's got movies, he's got action figures.
He's a well-known Felcher.
Right, yeah, yeah. He Felches all the time. He's kicks off of airplanes. He likes our show. He mentioned our show, and we hated his last movie, but we love him regardless. Nonetheless, we love Kevin Smith, and
he hated the last two, but I'm not counting.
Oh, yeah. Anyway. Jay Leno. But I was figuring let's do a top 10 list of, and I figured if Fernando was here, he could chime in and tell us his favorites.
That's a lot of figuring.
But yeah, apparently I overfigured because Fernando's not even here.
Yeah, whatever.
But we could do ours. Did you bring yours?
I did.
Okay. So this is top 10 Kevin Smith projects, basically, or ventures, if you will.
Stuff he's done.
Stuff Kevin Smith has done or he's behind, more or less. He's involved in some way. Not influenced, but he's got his hands dirty. He's stuck his hands deep in there. And so.
What am I hearing? Tusk, really? Major list?
Tusk did not make the list, but it's...
I was going to say, what the fuck's wrong with
it? It's just the theme music for the list.
Okay.
And I guess I'll go first, right?
Well, hurry up before the band starts.
Okay. number 10. Now, I was on the fence on this one.
Did it hurt?
felt pretty good.
What kind of a fence was it?
Wasn't too bad. But I'm going to go number 10. It was White Picket. So, good old American dream right up you. Right in there.
Right up
in your business.
Right up
you. Right up you. Number 10, Comic Book Man. Went with a TV show.
Yeah, but he's... Besides the little 5 minutes he spent, it's not really his show. It's their show.
It's his store.
He's
producer. He's there. That's his thing.
All right.
I'd say definitely.
Hey, it's your list. You can be wrong if you want. What else?
And I thought you'd have Comic Book Man on yours. Apparently, I don't. Apparently, you do not.
Not.
Okay. Now, number 9, a kind of an obscure choice, but I do enjoy it. Drawing Flies. It was a movie, and basically, he's a producer in it. Him and Scott Mosier are executive producers, financiers. Do you remember? It was Jason Lee, black and white independent, where he's with a group of kind of kids that are. Up in Canada, they're sort of on welfare, and they go hunting for Bigfoot. Remember that one?
Well, I remember the title, but that's all.
Actually, they don't go hunting for Bigfoot. Jason Lee leads them to believe they're going to his uncle's cabin. Jason Lee is looking for Bigfoot. There's no cabin, so spoilers, people. Sorry.
And hijinks ensue.
Somewhat, yeah.
Okay.
It's cool, and Kevin Smith actually plays Silent Bob in it. But the funny thing is, Jason Mewes has a starring role. He plays a whole different character, but they do pass each other at one time and look at each other like, hey, you know, kind of a, so.
Little nod.
Yeah, little nod. Yeah. So, pretty cool. Right after Mallrats, Jason Lee's next movie after that. Number 8, Clerks 2. That one you know, right?
I know that one, yes.
You like that one, right?
It didn't make my list.
No. Really?
Okay. Yeah, fine. You know what I just realized? I haven't been wearing headphones this whole time.
I noticed that earlier. I was going to say something, and I thought, yeah, whatever.
I don't mess up my hair.
Yeah. Your hair's rocking. You get banging hair today, so I wouldn't want to fuck with that. Yeah.
Don't fuck with perfection.
Number 7, Fat Man on Batman, the podcast. That's funny.
Okay. Well, I did it a little differently, but okay, yeah.
Did sure. you? Okay.
See, now it's bothering me, so now I gotta put them on now.
Okay.
All right. Go ahead.
There goes the do.
Number 6.
Oh, shit. Man, yeah, it's gonna take a while to fix that shit. Hope you're not going out after this.
I got product. I'm good.
Number 6, Clerks Animated Series.
Okay. That actually made my list.
Did it? Oh. Yeah, you love that thing. Who's driving? Bear driving.
Love is strong, but, you know.
Number 5, Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back.
Also made my
the
list.
The movie. Yeah? Number 4, Hollywood Babylon, the podcast.
Like I said, you and I did that a little differently, but okay.
Didn't include any podcast, did you?
That's not true.
Okay. All right, and well, number 3, 2, and 1 are kind of predictable. I don't know if they might be your top 3, but maybe in different order. Number 3, Clerks, the movie.
3? Really?
Yeah. Okay. Because I enjoyed number two, Chasing Amy, a little more.
Okay.
And, of course, my number one, the reason I won Disneyland tickets. Mallrats.
Fucking Mallrats.
Fucking Mallrats, which is going to get a sequel, hopefully, very shortly.
He's been saying that for a long time.
Right. Yeah. So.
And then there was going to be Clerks 3, and there was going to be,
You
don't believe about a Kevin Smith thing.
There was going to be Jersey Girl 2, yeah, until 2 you 3, see and 4.
It, until it's in a theater.
He does talk about a lot of stuff, and very, you know, a lot of it comes to...
Until it's in the can.
Yeah, yeah. So.
It's just spam.
Spam, 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 spam. Wonderful time. All right, let's hear yours. It's time, ladies and gentlemen. Jerry White's top 10 Kevin Smith list.
That was a total oversell for something that does not have the weight to justify that.
I'm sure it does. I'm sure your list is going to fucking rock.
No. Number 10 is Red State.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, it's... You know why? Because of the movies that aren't Kevin Smith-esque movies, it's the only good one.
Right.
Because Tusk was not, and Yoga Hosers was not.
Right,
and,
yeah.
But Red State was.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'll give him props for that. That was kind of a nod more than anything else.
Nod to, like...
And then I kind of group things. So, like, number 9 would be, like, the documentaries. Like, you know, An Evening With and...
Well, yeah.
And Evening Harder and... You know, all that
yeah, stuff. I was thinking An Evening With counts as you just all encompassing any, you know, because that's
those are the documentaries, so that's kind of
right. Yeah, yeah.
So I just did a general.
Yeah. No, one. that was gonna be my number 10. I was back and forth between Comic Book Man and An Evening With.
No one cares now, dude. We're not on your list anymore. We're on my list now. Who cares what you were gonna fucking do? Number 8 would be the animated series.
That's what I was gonna do. No, I'm just kidding. Go ahead.
The short-lived, the extremely short-lived animated series.
Yeah, you loved that.
Why do you keep saying I loved it? I liked it.
You thoroughly enjoyed it. Than most.
It got the shit kicked out of it by Family Guy, which means it didn't live long. Well, but
it was ahead of its time. It needed to find its audience.
All the shit that doesn't make it. People say it was ahead of its time.
Right, yeah.
It doesn't mean it was ahead of its time. It
just you had to think too hard to get the jokes because they were just too... like,
dude, you are full of shit. My God. Let's see. Number 7 would be, like, anything... All the Smodcast stuff. And I'm including, like, Hollywood Babylon and
Jay. You can't do that!
I can do whatever the fuck I want.
That's my wrong! List. You did wrong.
Jay and Silent Bob Get Old, all that stuff.
That's two different things. You got Putin and you got the Jello. No, that's fine.
Okay.
I'm
glad it's fine because I was fucking worried. I'm sitting there going, God, what if this is not fine with him?
I'll go ahead and just accept. The judges say okay.
That's a load off.
Oh, you've got a load off coming.
Stop it. Now, here's one you didn't think of. Delivery. 6. Yeah. Zach and Mary Make a Porno.
I do. I like Zach and Mary Make a Porno.
That was a good movie.
And I thought about putting it here, but...
So now who's the fucking tard?
Honestly, it would be number 12 on my list. I do like it. It's good.
This is going to piss you off. Mallrats is 5 for me.
Oh, blasphemy. 5. Jesus Christ.
Stupid.
Are you kidding me?
And I would have put it down farther, but I knew you'd just have a... Felching fit if I did,
Yeah, that's what I think. Yeah. I'm felching right now. It's felch, everybody. Felch with me. Yeah, that's a good felch. Yeah, okay. Enough felching.
Number 4, Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back.
That's pretty close to where I got mine.
Yeah, but mine's better.
It's uncanny how similar we are.
Here's another one. Actually, ours are nothing similar at all. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
I swear we're the same person.
No, I'm better looking than you.
Got better hair, anyway.
Got better hair.
Until you put those headphones on.
Number 3 would be Dogma. Another one you didn't mention.
I didn't... You know, I'm not a real big Dogma guy. Although, obviously, it's great. I love it. It's good Kevin Smith movie. But
What's-Her-Face plays God.
Alanis Morissette?
Yeah. Alanis Morissette plays God.
Right, yeah.
That's genius right there.
That is pretty cool.
I admit, a stroke of fucking genius.
Coming at you, right
coming
there.
Coming at you, right Sign there.
It's still delivered.
Felching your heart.
But some people dogma, some people are like really, really, hey, I'm dogma. I'm all about dogma. Kevin Smith's best movie. Other people like me are like, dogma's a good movie, but it's not in my top 10. And other people are like, fucking hate Kevin Smith.
Who are these other people?
Fuck them. Who knows?
Fuck them.
Yeah.
They're all felchers.
They like to felch.
I had Chase and Amy at 2, because Chase and Amy was very good. And I had the original Clerks, because I had to, number 1.
Right, yeah. So almost like my list.
It's nothing close to my list at all.
It's like we felched each other's list.
See, because...
Felcher's list.
This is wrong. And my much more professional list here is right.
I think they're both a pretty solid. How about, can you take the high road? Can you be the bigger man and admit that?
Have you fucking met me? The high road. I don't even know where the high road is. This is the guy who took his kid to Bad Santa too.
Right, right, yeah.
The high road. Do they have felching on the high road?
I'm sure it could be negotiated.
Wow.
If whatever gets you there, huh?
Do you have geek announcements?
I do have a few geek announcements.
I think you did.
Do you have any bathroom adventures before I get into geek announcements?
No.
No? I bet you do, and you're just not sharing.
Well, so. Sharing is caring.
And you don't care. You don't give a shit.
Nope.
Okay, well, geek announcements. This is kind of cool. Some people may not agree. Max Landis is remaking American Werewolf in London. Now, Max Landis, of course, the son of John Landis, who made the original American Werewolf in London. So, kind of cool. I don't know. You like that movie?
No.
No?
Just stomped on that thing's throat, didn't I?
If you did, if you loved that movie, would you be outraged at this, or would you say, cool?
Well, I don't do hypothetical.
Really? Okay.
Or at least not right there.
All right.
I don't care.
All right. One thing, side note, fun fact, another one. First DVD I ever owned, American Werewolf in London. And I had to climb on top of a building to get it.
No.
Yeah. I should have told this on the Halloween show, but I was at a Halloween party at Pompeii, or what used to be Pompeii, that club. It's kind of different levels and stuff. Mm-hmm. A friend of mine, Troy Zimmer, I know you're listening out there. He won American Werewolf in London in a contest.
Suckdodes.
And he's like, suckdodes. he said, hey, you want this? I'm like, yeah, I'll take it. He's like, go get it. Fucking threw it up on the roof. And I'm like, damn it. And I had just gotten a DVD player, but had no DVDs. I got one for Christmas. No, couldn't have been, because Halloween was coming. For some reason, I had a DVD player and no DVDs. I climbed up on, like, I had to climb up in a costume. I was like in a fucking lounge suit, climb up on the roof to get this thing.
Troy's kind of a dick.
And yeah, well, you know,
it's kind of a dick move.
He was drunk. He had just had a few.
Oh, well, that makes it alright.
And David Naughton, who stars in American Werewolf in London, I was a extra in a movie with him, and you were there with me. We went to the theater and saw it. Right. 1,000 Cuts.
So I was there.
Yeah, we went the Palm Springs Film Festival.
Yeah. Did I enjoy it?
You enjoyed the movie. You said you didn't see me. You probably blinked, because my scene was pretty quick. But anyway, Max Landis remaking American Werewolf in London. If anyone's going to remake it, I'd say let him do it. He's the kid of the guy that made it before, so.
That logic doesn't really hold water.
Do you have a favorite John Landis movie?
You'd have to list them, then I could tell you.
Blues Brothers.
That would be one of them, but.
I figured that'd be it.
Animal House.
Is that his?
Animal House? Yeah. Landis?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah. Yeah. Into the Night is my favorite. Jeff Goldblum, Michelle Pfeiffer.
You know what my first DVD was?
What is it? Yeah, I was going to ask you.
Your mom banging some plumber dude.
That was my second DVD.
I think you copied my copy.
I had to climb a mountain to get that one. Troy had that one too. He threw it. You want this? Go get it. I was fucking.
This plumber guy was laying pipe to your mom, man.
Oh, I get it. Laying pipe.
Laying pipe.
All right, Harley Quinn movie.
They don't need to do that.
They're gonna do it, but it's gonna. The cool thing is, it's gonna be a Birds of Prey movie. So it's gonna be. She, even though Harley Quinn is the main character, she's sort of like the antagonist, where the Birds of Prey, probably Black Canary, Huntress, maybe Barbara Gordon, either as Batgirl or Oracle, they're going to have to hunt her down. But she's, I don't know, it's she stole the show in Suicide Squad. I don't agree.
How hard was that, though?
Yeah, right, yeah.
There's a whole lot of else going on.
She stole all the scene from Captain Boomerang, so... But it's going to happen, and it's going to be a Birds of Prey movie, basically, but they're going to call it Harley Quinn, I guess, more or less. Now, here's a big question on everyone's mind. Will Michael Bay direct a Marvel or DC comic books movie? Comics movie.
If Marvel lets Bay direct,
uh-huh,
I will never go again.
Well,
if DC does it, I'll just go, yeah, that's fucking
that'd
DC.
That typical, yeah.
If Marvel does it, I will never go to a Marvel movie again.
Well, I would say DC already has its Michael Bay and Zack Snyder, but his answer, I wouldn't want to. It's not my thing. It's just not my gig.
Yeah, it's good. I wouldn't want to do a Marvel movie. They're good.
Yeah.
Good is not my thing.
He says that he has a greater interest in creating his own universe, as he did with Transformers, rather than stepping into one that's already started.
Yeah, he stepped into it already.
Yeah, we all stepped into it.
Just in case anybody didn't already know, Transformer movies suck fucking balls.
Well, did
every single one of them suck fucking balls.
Now, I don't know if you saw it, the Transformers Last Night trailer just dropped. So
yeah, dropped. It looked word.
Yeah. It looks like it could be the best one yet, but I guess that's not saying much. And then the other question, will Tyler Perry direct a Marvel movie? No, not really. Now, Spider-Man Homecoming star Tom Holland is in talks for a lead role in Doug Liman's sci-fi thriller Chaos Walking. Doug Liman, again, directed Swingers.
Mm-hmm.
If he signs on, he'll portray a main character, a boy who, after discovering a terrible secret about his hometown, is forced to run away with his trusty dog. So it's some sort of sci-fi invasion type movie. So, now, does... yeah, whatever, huh? Does convincing new evidence confirm John Cleese... Oh, I got your attention now.
How could you tell?
...is going to be in a DC movie role? Sources say that John Cleese's Twitter account has recently begun following both Ben Affleck and Justice League director Zack Snyder. So... that may show that maybe he's... either he's just interested in DC movies and shit, or he's might be doing some research and we might see John Cleese in a DC role.
Okay.
That'd be kind of cool, though, wouldn't it?
Cleese?
Yeah, yeah.
I guess.
Who would he play? He might be... maybe he's Green Lantern.
The Minister of Silly Walks?
Yeah. Well, he's already done that.
I don't know.
Could be Green Lantern or...
Cleese.
Sinestro would be like, you won't catch me, Green Lantern. Yes, I will. No, you won't. Yes, I will. Too easy. I don't know.
You actually set yourself up for that one.
No, I didn't. That's top.
Yes,
of,
you did.
That's off the cuff. But speaking of Green Lantern.
No, you're not.
a member of Green Lantern Corps will be seen in Justice League in a key sequence. That's this upcoming movie. We thought we wouldn't see any Green Lantern. We're going to see... at least a member of the Corps. Could be John Stewart, could be Guy Gardner, could be Hal Jordan, could be Meekit. But yeah, no further details are specified, so we have no idea which member of the Corps this will be. So, but we're gonna get to see some sort of Green Lantern action. So,
and they expect me to be able to sleep at night, not knowing. Fucking whatever, DC.
Yeah, I know. Now, Freddy...
so you have to actually make a couple of really good movies in a row for people to start caring about shit like that.
Right, yeah.
Until
yeah.
that happens, it's like, okay. Fucking whatever.
Well, it's, you know, it's exciting. I mean, we thought we weren't going
to
get...
it's supposed to be exciting. Yeah, it's...
but it's... yeah.
But it's not until they actually show that they can put in the work.
Right, yeah.
You know, until they can bring it.
Yeah. Bring it and bring it hard. Okay.
I'd settle for just bringing it.
Yeah. Don't give them too much. Well, okay. Last
the bar too high.
Yeah. Last but not least, Freddie Mercury has been cast in the Queen movie.
He's dead, right?
Yeah. He's cat. Someone else is going to play him. So, yeah. He's not casting him in some other movie. Somebody's been casted as him.
That'd have been a good trick.
Right, yeah. Would have been awesome. So Mr. Robot star Rami Malek.
I've never seen that show. I hear it's really good.
Yeah? Huh. Well, apparently this guy is going to play Freddie Mercury.
Mm.
So he must be good at that. I'd like to see Mr. Robot. What is it about?
I don't know.
Okay.
I just hear it's really good.
Well, Rami Malek will play the role, and the Usual Suspects director Bryan Singer, also known for X-Men movies, have signed on for the Queen film titled Bohemian Rhapsody. Yeah, didn't give that a lot of thought, but
to say, take a minute.
Cool. Yeah, so we have a Freddie Mercury.
I guess Fat Bottom Girls wouldn't have gone over as well.
Called a bicycle.
Yeah.
So, did you do a Freddie Mercury impression? You're a singer, right? Could you do one off the cuff?
No.
Come on, people are listening.
No, I'm good.
Just 1 year of love! Good job, Jared. That's not bad. Thank you.
Well, I don't even know what that was. What was that?
It's a B-side. B-side they have. So, that being said... I want to thank Fernando, our guest, for...
Man, you will not get off the top of your ass, will you? My God.
We had big money for you.
So, you're being more of a bitch about that than I am.
So, join us. This has been the Idol Effect.
You didn't give show info.
Oh, okay.
Why do I always have to remind you to give show info?
Show info. Okay. Well, you can find us on Facebook. There is a...
small fee.
Yeah. Just go to Facebook and search Idol Effect. We pretty much pop up.
Double dog fucking dare you.
You can find us on YouTube, and you can email us. Do we have any emails? No? Nobody loves us?
No one loves us this time.
Okay.
I haven't checked either, but I'm guessing no one loves us.
Okay. Well, it's idoleffect@yahoo.com, correct?
Or Yahoo,
yeah. And, of course, you can listen to us on iTunes and Podbean. Now, join us. Guess what's right around the corner here, Jer, coming up?
Groundhog Day.
Besides Rogue One, we got our Christmas show coming up, and it's going to be like a Rogue One review, assuming we see the movie, and a Christmas show.
That would make sense.
So, join us if you will for episode 18. We're going to be back with a Rogue One review, spoiler review, and we're going to talk a little Christmas. And Jared's going to prepare. He loves Christmas, and he's going to go all out this year. You are going to be... If you love Christmas, tune in. Jared's got something for you.
I'm going to felt you.
So, having said that, thank you very much, everybody. Join us next... in 2 weeks. We'll be right back. Sing it, Bruce. Sing it, boss.